The Atlas Coal Mine is the most complete historic coal mine site in Canada and also home to the last standing wooden coal tipple in our country. The mine site remains as a look back into the vast history of mining in the Drumheller Valley.
This was the very last coal mine in the Drumheller Valley to operate. Out of 139 coal mines from the Tyrone Museum, about 40 kilometers away to here, this was the very last mine. And well, at one time before oil and gas was king in Western Canada, coal was king, and Drumheller was the crown jewel of King Coal. And it was Drumheller coal that they used in the 20th century to run the trains, bring people out west. It was Drumheller coal that we used to heat our houses when we were cold, cook our food when we're hungry, and turn on our lights when it was dark.
The Atlas Coal Mine also has their resident storyteller, a man who lived and worked as a miner, Bob Moffat.
For myself, I was a fifth generation miner. And this is my heritage, as it is for hundreds of the people who are still in the valley here. We're losing our miners every day. There aren't many of us left. If we can continue to keep this place running and tell people the stories of what it was like back then, that makes me so happy. What we try to do is explain to them exactly how tough this life was. And it was tough, whether you worked in 40 below, up in that tipple with no heat, your sandwich is frozen solid, and your hot tea down to lukewarm if you were lucky. The underground, where you went down, and every day, I guess your life was at stake because you're waiting for the roof to come down.
It's through these stories and lessons that a vivid picture of the conditions in the mine are painted.
These are your work clothes. You would have your soap and your towel hanging up here, and the odd guy that was kind of a dandy, he would even have a razor, he'd shave up a bit. And you can't think of a cheaper way to have a locker than this.
Yeah.
And if you were all sweaty, by the time you came back, they were dry because the heat rises.
This is a carbide light. This is an open flame light that they wore in Drumheller Valley. Other mines in other mining regions used them too, but they used these up until the mid-1950s. It's got two parts. It's got a lower chamber, and this is where I'm going to put calcium carbide. It's a manufactured substance. It's a combination of coking coal, lime, and a few other things. By itself, it doesn't do much, but when you mix it with water, which is in the upper chamber, it creates acetylene gas.
There you go. Nice little bang.
That was good.
Yeah. The more water you put in, the longer the flame you got.
The next plan for this historic site is to raise enough money to reopen the closed end of the mine to expand their tours.
When they closed this mine, they dynamited at least 100 feet by law to close that main entry into the mine to keep people and animals out. What we've started to do here is to dig that out and re-timber as we go in. Now, if we can get back into the mine, we feel that it being a dry mine, we'll be able to re-timber just for safety's sake and be able to take people right in to a coal face.
For more information on the mine, go to atlascoalmine.ab.ca. Jordan Greenlee, Go Central.